Hi everyone, I hope you're ready for amazingness. It's time to look at plugins in Adobe XD. Now there's lots of plugins. We're gonna, in this case, look at a Lorem Ipsum plugin because it's nice and easy. But throughout this course, we're gonna look at more and more plugins as we go. What is a plugin? So Adobe, when they made XD, when they're making it, they've built all the kind of core features for it, okay? Plus some really other cool stuff like the repeat grid and character styles and the assets panel. So they've done some really nice stuff. What they've allowed though is they've said to the world, if you know how to make a plugin, you can go into development and make one. So if you are a software engineer or a codey nerdy type person, you can make your own plugins. So they've given really good documentation for people to go off and make plugins. The cool thing about that is it's just stuff that's missing. And then somebody's gone off and like, I'm gonna make something to fix that problem. And the benefit for us is that we don't have to wait for Adobe to do it. Somebody else can do it, add it to the library, and we can use it. Let's look at making one. So we're gonna use, first of all, let's look at the plugins. So go to plugins along the top here and go to discover plugins. So plugins are coming out all the time. I'm gonna cover a few in this course, but latest release is a great place to get started, I guess, in terms of which ones. So these ones all come out today. Okay, so brand new today. I haven't even gone through them yet. So I'll have a look through these as we go through the course, but you do the same. There's gonna be stuff in here that's gonna be new. They do all sorts of different things. Pattern Maker, Color Blend. Ooh, what else is nice? User Images, we'll do that later on. The one we want for the moment is in here in search. We're gonna go to Lorem, just type in Lorem. So we've done Lorem Ipsum, remember it's the placeholder text. So this one here works, you can click on See Details. It tells you a little bit about it before you install it. Click Install when you're ready. It'll tell you it's installed when it's finished. There it is, I'm gonna close it down. And they appear here in the plugins panel. You can see you've got a few already installed. This is the one we're gonna use. So they all have their quirks. This particular one, you have to grab the type tool. You have to draw out an area type box because it needs to fill it, right? So it needs a width. You need to have some text in there, some text. If you, it's a weird quirk with XD, if you don't have any text in a text box, watch this. You might have noticed this already. If I do this and I forget to type in it, it's no longer there. It's like completely gone forever. So just jam in some text, get it to be the right size. Like in our case, we're going to use the Roboto 16 point. So I'll use my style there. You have to have it selected with the black arrow. Otherwise this doesn't work. There's a lot of rules for this plugin. And you can't be in your cursor like this. You can't have your text kind of highlighted or your cursor flashing. You have to be on the black arrow. Cool. So we've got a text box. I want to add some placeholder text. I'm going to go to plugins, Lorem Ipsum, and I'm going to go to quick Lorem Ipsum. And it just throws it in there. How much better is it than going to this file here that I gave you at the beginning and opening it, and copying and pasting it? Not much when this thing is open, but going and finding that file that Dan gave you in that course a year ago can be tough. So a little plugin like this, super quick, super easy. Let's have a look at some of the options for it. So we went to the quick fill Lorem Ipsum. Let's look at this one here. Okay, this top option gives you a few more extra things. So by default, that's what it's given us. We can turn off line breaks if we want. This one here doesn't do a hot, can you see there's this empty gap at the bottom? This is gonna trim that box, look. You see, it just tucked it up nicely at the end here. Handy, I guess. Next thing I wanna do is in here, same thing. You can use the shortcut. Is Lorem Ipsum might be useful. You could use the Cicero option. What is the Cicero option? I might butcher this, but I think Lorem Ipsum is just mixed up Latin words, but they mixed it up based on something. And it was an essay by this old Roman dude. Now he wasn't just an old Roman dude. He was a famous old Roman dude. But anyway, they've derived that this original kind of mixed up Lorem Ipsum came from an essay of his, and you can use it. The only difference really for me, because I don't speak Latin, well not today anyway, is that that's actually proper structure, whereas Lorem Ipsum's all mixed up. But for me, it doesn't matter because it's all mixed up. What else can you do? Just quickly, same one. There's this one here. Pentagram is the quick brown fox. Got all the letters available, which might be handy when you're kind of doing like this stuff. You want all the fonts to, or see what all the characters look like. Now I can't think of anything else it does. You can do different languages, which is cool for placeholder text. And what you'll also find out, if you're using the exact same plugin, it might be updated and there might be different things it can do. I love it if the shortcut worked. The moment that shortcut actually zooms in and out of my XD, they kind of battle with other things in here. And also, just so you know, XD doesn't allow you at the moment to go into preferences, which is real weird. I'd like to go in there, maybe play around with keyboard shortcuts. That will change as well. But if you're like Googling, why is it grayed out? You will find a forum post that says, oh, we've done that on purpose because it doesn't work. And then you'll think to yourself, why did you put it in? And then they say it has to be because of something Mac does. Anyway, at the moment you can't change any of the preferences and you can't update the keyboard shortcuts, which I can't wait to do because I'd love some of these plugins to be a keyboard shortcut that actually worked. Be awesome. All right, we kind of looked at Lauren Ipsum, but really we're looking at plugins in general and how they extend the ability of Adobe XD. We'll throw more in the course as we go along. I just want to throw in nice and early here to get used to them, and we'll do more as we go along. All right, I will see you in the next video. Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up, it really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.